Respected ABC journalist Paul Lockyer has been farewelled by the Australian media, farmers, friends and family. They were among more than 600 who paid tribute to a man loved across both the city and the country.
They'd come to celebrate the life of one of the news industry's favourite sons, but it was Paul Lockyer's own sons who perhaps fittingly did it best.
The one thing he'd always emphasised was to keep it short and sweet. He loved the little things in life. And I think that's what made him the world's greatest dad.
A loving husband for 38 years, the best father for 28 years, and a tragic spoon player for 61 years.
Good mate Ray Martin tried to sum up a remarkable 42-year career.
Paul Lockyer reported widely from the killing fields of Cambodia to the cocaine fields of Colombia. He'd reported from Washington, and years later, of course, the bush and the drought and the flooding rains became Paul's signature.
Many had come from the country to say goodbye, including Grantham resident Kel Wood, who met Paul in the aftermath of the floods.
He talked to lockers because they all trusted him.
Another boy from the bush, Michael O'Brien, spoke of his legacy.
Rural Australia loved Paul Lockyer. And how I know this, people would ring me. Mike, saw you on the telly the other night. Get onto that Lockyer bloke and tell him he's on the right track. He's doing a tremendous job for us.
A favourite poem was read.
I love a sunburnt country, a land of sweeping plains.
But the most poignant words were the veteran journalist's own, written about the place where he died last week, Lake Eyre.
Not a creature to be seen, not even a bush fly. Just the crunch of salt underfoot and the whistling of the wind. In this vast void constructed over millions of years, there's a deep sense of man's insignificance.
Not this man. Paul Lockyer was 61.